Salutations, Celestial Sightseers. I'm David Fuller. Welcome to Eyes on the Sky. What's up this week? Crossing the meridian in mid-July, after it gets dark for most of us, is Ophiuchus. How did this physician in the sky come to be? That's the subject of this episode's Astronomy Theater. In Roman lore, Asclepius was the son of the god Apollo and the mortal Coronis, and trained to be a physician. While thinking on how to heal a patient, a snake climbed up his wooden staff. Frightened, Asclepius killed the snake.
I hate snakes!
But then another one came along with an herb that restored the dead snake back to life. Using the same herb, he learned to bring humans back to life. But Pluto complained to Zeus, who struck Asclepius dead with a thunderbolt arrow. But at the intervention of his father Apollo, Asclepius was placed in the sky by Zeus. His name means serpent bearer, as that was how he learned his healing art. Even today, the rod of Asclepius is found as a symbol of medicine, though it is sometimes confused with the caduceus. Ophiuchus is a large constellation, the 11th largest in the entire night sky. In the northern reaches of the Good Doctor, there's a section that protrudes towards the east. It's here that we'll set our sights this week. The 2.8 magnitude Beta Ophiuchi, or Sebelrai, makes a convenient guidepost to several objects to see near here. The brightest and easiest to find is IC4665, sometimes known as the High Cluster, for its resemblance to the capital letters H and I when seen through a reflector telescope. It is somewhat young-ish as open clusters go, having formed some 40 million years ago at a distance of 1,400 light-years. Best seen at very low power, the cluster is also visible in binoculars from most areas, as most of the bright stars are 7th and 8th magnitude. And now this week's Dark Sky Fact. Blue light at night harms sleep by suppressing melatonin. The best outdoor street lights are low-pressure sodium, but other lights that do not emit light in wavelengths shorter than 540 nanometers are okay too, such as high-pressure sodium, provided they are well-shielded to block glare and light trespass, of course. For best sleep conditions, in indoor situations, use incandescent, halogen, or warm white LEDs to limit blue wavelengths exposure after dark. From Beta Ophiuchi, things get interesting. 70 Ophiuchi, a double star, is located less than 6 degrees from Beta, and it's easy to find too. Just hop 2 degrees to Gamma, 3 degrees to 67 Ophiuchi, and then 1 additional degree to 70. This double star is a mere 16.6 light years from Earth, with 2 K spectral class stars orbiting around a barycenter. These two stars have an average distance of a bit more than the furthest out Sun-Uranus distance. However, their orbit is highly elliptical, so we get this mesmerizing dance between the two stars, like this. One orbit takes just over 83 years, so many of us can at least observe and plot half an orbit, or more, over our lifetimes, depending on when one starts our observations. So keep good notes. The angular separation varies from 6.7 arc seconds to as close as 1.7, and is currently a bit less than 4. Their colors have been variously described as yellow and red, or gold and violet. What colors do you see? And lastly, we can find one of the closest stars to Earth. Barnard's star is just 5.9 light years away, and also has a very fast proper motion, moving over 10 arc seconds per year. It is just north and west of the triangle of stars formed by 66, 67, and 70 Ophiuchi. Follow an arcing line from 70 through 66, 4th and 5th magnitude stars respectively, and look for this lambda-shaped set of stars. These are largely 7th through 9th magnitude, and Barnard's star is 10.5 magnitude. Draw a line from the apex of the lambda, and in a 1 degree field of view, you can spot the fast-moving star here. If you like this video, there are more videos like it and others with basic telescope information. Visit eyesonthesky.com and click on the Videos tab or choose from the drop-down menus. And be sure to subscribe, follow, or like on social media sites. Eyes on the Sky is more than just weekly astronomy videos. Thanks for watching. Keep your eyes on the sky and your outdoor lights aimed down so we can all see what's up. I'm David Fuller, wishing you clear and dark skies.